Hi, Laura, and welcome to our interview today. I'm really excited that Laura's joining us from Cultiva Kingdom. I did an Instagram live this week and we were discussing the dress that I wore for London Fashion Week, which was made from hemp. And during our discussion, we were talking about how we can, as individuals, think more about the clothing we're wearing and about the impact it's having on the environment. So, Laura, I'm absolutely delighted to have you here with me today. It's an interview we have planned for a while. So, welcome.
Thank you very much. It's such a great honor to talk about this subject with you because I feel like we cross paths in a great way, and it's a really interesting subject to explore when you're looking at sustainability, but also the impact these materials actually have on your skin.
So I know during our IG live we did kind of delve a little bit into the dress that I was wearing. And if anybody wants to hear more about that, that interview is on my Instagram platform. So do sort of go over and have a tune into that. But for today, Laura, we're going to be talking a little bit more about sustainable fashion and your hemp as well, how you got involved in that. I'm really sort of keen, first of all, for you to tell us a little bit about yourself, so that the audience know a bit about who you are.
Sure. So obviously, as you said, I was the founder of Cultiva Kingdom, and it's been an incredible journey, to be honest. It's something that I think I came into just at the right time, and I really started my journey because I've actually been suffering with eczema my entire life, and it's something that I've always been thinking about is how sensitive my skin was to materials. And as I got older, I kind of realized, certain things did flare up my eczema, and that was particularly stuff like silicon or rubbers or working with certain materials when I was creating my artwork at university. And at that point, I suppose I started to delve into more the kind of natural fibers and trying to understand this kind of impact of synthetics on your skin. From there, I was very lucky enough to have the opportunity to work at a hemp farm in Pangbourne, and during my placement at university, and that's really where I dropped across the idea of hemp as a solution for the textile industry. And when I was there, I asked them questions. Are you growing fiber for fashion? Are you making this stuff? And they said, no, it doesn't happen in the UK. We just grow hemp seed and CBD, or we produce these products. And it was really interesting. And I went home that day, I remember, and I found all this history about how we used to produce hemp fiber and textiles in the UK, and we had a strong history for making these products for the war. We were making it for sales for uniforms, and unfortunately, we lost a lot of the machinery after the war. We sold it off to countries in Asia, places like China, who have been doing it for centuries, and they're experts in what they're doing. But unfortunately, it left us in a very big hole of this gap of knowledge, and my journey was to kind of bring this history back to the UK. And in the last 3 years, we've actually just seen a huge amount of people now being very involved, and especially in this last year of kind of looking at the pandemic, a lot of people actually thought, well, actually, we do need to look at a local supply. We've been cut off from Europe, obviously, and other countries through the pandemic, and everything's getting stuck at customs, and we're now looking at this local issue, and it's something that we are still working on, and I think it still has some time. It's not going to happen quickly, but the good news is research is now going into the right places, and we're seeing a lot of people taking a huge interest in it. And I really hope to see it kind of blossom in the next 5 years at least. And it's very exciting to be a part of it.
I mean, we're talking about this going back to the war, like, so hemp being used, many years ago, it's something that I would find quite unimaginable, in the sense of, you know, this product, this was actually being used, and then all of a sudden it stops. I mean, there is, like you said, a gap right now. How do you think people are starting to, I mean, how have you started to now kind of incorporate using hemp in the products and the clothing range that you're introducing and manufacturing? Like, how has that all come about? Because surely that would have been quite challenging, the initial stages of you kind of getting that together.
Yes, it was. I mean, I've spent the last 3 years talking to producers all around the world and understanding their processes, and really understanding which ones are chemically based and which ones are using much better processes, not using chemicals, obviously, and moving more towards mechanical and natural dyeing, which is what we need to ensure the safety of these products on our skin and our body. And it has been testing. I mean, it's a lot of working with manufacturers and sampling products. But the beautiful thing about this fiber is you can do so much with it. People are building houses with the stalk, and we use the bast fiber from that to then create woven fabrics, you know, potentially knitted fabrics, and then we start designing really unique products. So we have a great selection of, you know, accessories. We have hemp sunglasses, we have the dress, we do hemp silk blouses and robes, which is beautiful because it's all very soft and silky and it drapes on the skin. And people have this kind of thought that hemp is very coarse and rough and itchy, but actually what we're proving is it's not like that anymore. With our advanced technologies that have been produced over the last couple of years, we are now cottonizing that fabric, and it's because it's very soft and very viable for different products.
And I imagine that as you've, you know, been working with the product so closely, and because of your eczema as well, you've been sort of trialing and testing various products on your skin. Could you tell us a bit more on, like, the impact and what you've noticed when you've been using these products on your skin?
Sure. I would say that the great benefit of natural fibers, especially something with hemp, is it's very breathable. So what you're doing is you're allowing the skin to breathe and not get so sweaty. And that is one of the biggest issues I have faced with kind of synthetic materials, is you get this sweat, and the sweat builds up, and that's what flares the skin up. So it's definitely something that I have continued to do wearing. I mean, organic cotton is still much better than synthetics for that reason, but it's the hemp has much more durability, and therefore it lasts a lot longer. It's not just kind of one benefit to this. There's a huge range of benefits of just working with hemp, and also the way it can be blended with other materials. So we actually blend it with other natural fibers and sources like wood pulp, for example.
And I think anyone that's watching this who has got a visible skin condition or struggling with an aspect of, you know, their skin, it's quite interesting to kind of read about this a bit further, because it's not just eczema, but even with vitiligo, it's a skin condition that does, you know, get easily, it does easily sort of spread, it does easily spread when, you know, stress exacerbates it a lot more. And you know, when we think about vitiligo as well, sometimes when you've kind of hurt yourself, you'll notice a new patch of vitiligo. And sometimes, you know, when you think about the context of clothing and what you're applying, if you've got a fabric that's then going to rub onto that surface area, then the vitiligo patches could spread because, you know, you are irritating and you're rubbing that against the skin. So I think these are all kind of things to consider, like yourself, Laura, it's eczema, but even with a skin condition like psoriasis, I mean, this does sort of broaden out quite a lot, doesn't it, to other skin conditions as well.
Exactly. And what I discovered is actually a huge amount of people in this country do suffer with these skin conditions. You know, 1 million people of UK British people actually do suffer with eczema, and it's a big problem. And from what I've noticed, a lot of it is down to kind of pollution as well, and polluted areas. People in those who live in those areas are much more likely to suffer. And something that my mum did when I was very young was throw me into the sea at any opportunity, and it was it works wonders for the skin. So I've always come from that background of working with nature and appreciating it, and hemp is my next step in that journey of how can it help the skin. So yeah, it's been incredible.
And in terms of, you know, we're talking about nature and you know, like your mum throwing you into the water, that natural sort of those natural ingredients going into your skin. I mean, when we think about nature and the environment, you know, can you talk to us about a little bit more about the environmental benefits that hemp has?
Sure. So what I will start off by saying is 64% of our fabrics are actually synthetic based. And only 1% of that is recycled. So the biggest problem we're facing right now is all this synthetic plastic material going into landfill. And it's actually destroying our ecosystems as well, because the microfibers that are coming off these fabrics are not breaking down. And they're forever kind of going around our ecosystems and being eaten by fish and animals. And therefore we eat it, and we're actually ingesting this plastic too. And this is the biggest problem. So what hemp does firstly is it is 100% biodegradable as a natural fiber, and as I said, it's long lasting, so we're developing products that would last a long time, and then when you're finished with them they will actually just naturally decompose. But when you look at hemp as an actual plant, we see that it uses only 1/3 of the water that cotton would, so we're saving huge amounts of water, which is vital at the moment when water is so scarcely resourced now. And it also does not require pesticides or herbicides, so we're saving the chemicals in the land, and actually hemp can recover the soil as well as a bioremediation crop, so we're actually fixing the soil as well as putting less chemicals on it. And again, this is great because you're putting less chemicals on your skin too, so it's a cycle, but it all works, and it's all really just revitalizing all the problems that really cotton has wiped out over the last 100 years, and we're now fixing it with hemp.
Well, you know, every time that I sort of turn on the TV or read a magazine or a blog or something online, you know, you know, we're always hearing about people that are trying to sort of go down the natural route. You know, people want to try and make more of an effort to be more environmentally friendly, start using natural products on their skin as opposed to a cream that's got lots of chemicals and you know, numbers, enum, I don't know what sort of numbers and extra additives and things added to it. So we're always, you know, I think a lot of people are trying to kind of go down that route of using more kind of ethical products. What would you say to someone who would say, for example, you know, but I find that a lot of sustainable clothing, ethical clothing costs a lot more, and you know, for me it wouldn't be financially viable. Like what kind of things would you say to someone who, you know, would sort of pose that question?
It is a great question. I think recently this is becoming more of a problem, especially since the pandemic has, you know, caused a lot of people to lose their jobs, and my fear at the beginning of all of this was that people couldn't afford to be sustainable, and it shouldn't be a cost really. It should be a choice, and it should be affordable. And unfortunately, a lot of companies, they greenwash what they're doing and put a price on it, and it can be an issue. And unfortunately, hemp is a part of that, just because we're not growing enough for it to be so economically viable. But again, as I'm saying, with research and facilities going up in the right places, I do believe that cost is going to come down eventually. And people, what I would say is they need to see it as an investment. The fact that they're supporting this stuff now means that they're showing to stakeholders and brands that they are, the demand is there. And that's what we need to prove to people, that there is a need for this stuff. And once that need is there, then the, you know, hopefully the industries will start growing around it. And that's exactly what we've seen with CBD. The other the other part of the plant of hemp is CBD, is a cannabinoid, and it has been very helpful for people. And what we saw is within 2-3 years it boomed, and now and now it's a huge industry worth billions of pounds. So that just gives us a lot of hope that the textile side will follow. But it is a great point, and I think maybe people do need to be a bit more savvy. You know, what annoyed me the other day, for example, was I went into a supermarket and they were now selling reusable bags to pick up your fruit. And I thought, oh, that's a great idea. We're reducing our plastic. We're encouraging people to take a little bag and put their fruit in it. But what the biggest problem was, it was a plastic bag. So it doesn't work. You have to kind of look through and see, you know, the long-term gain of these initiatives. And that was something that I wasn't that pleased about. So you have to be savvy, I think, with how you're being sustainable, kind of look into the longer term and maybe ask questions, you know, who's made this, where's it come from? And sometimes it is hard to give those answers because supply chains are not as transparent as we wish they were, especially for the fashion industry. But again, this is something we're all working on. We're all pushing the industry to be more transparent with us and our customers. And a lot of that is to do with now tracking all the procedures, even using blockchain. So this is where technology is coming in to really help these solutions.
And, you know, I think just on a final note, I think a lot of it's to do, and we did touch on this a little bit in our Instagram live, but it is about educating people as well. So in terms of, you know, going out and buying clothing that you think is cheaper, but actually it's not going to be durable. It's not going to have that longevity of a you know, lifespan. You know, we need to think about the pros and cons of things. Having something that's going to last us a lot longer over something that is potentially going to last us only a few months. When it goes in the wash, it doesn't come out the same. And then we end up throwing it away and just sort of going round in this sort of vicious cycle of, you know, buying clothes, you know, like that with a quick turnaround. I think it does come down to education. It does come down to that understanding. But it also, I think, the like you did say, the pandemic has allowed us to stop, reflect, and to think about the necessities of life and what we really need over what we're sort of going out and getting for the sake of it. So, Laura, you've touched on some fantastic points today. And Laura and I are going to be going into part two, where we're going to be talking about the effects of these products, of the hemp products, on the skin. And we're going to be elaborating on that a little bit more. So do stay tuned as Laura and I delve into this discussion a bit further. And we hope to see you in part two of our conversation on sustainable clothing. Thank you, Laura, for joining me today.
Thank you very much. I look forward to our next round of discussions.
Thank you. So guys, do stay tuned to my YouTube channel. Next week, I will be talking to Laura a little bit more about the effects of hemp on our skin. If you struggle with a skin condition and you're interested on this topic and to know a little bit more about how natural products and hemp can support you know, the clothing that you are wearing, and just understanding this topic a little bit further, don't forget to tune in next week, where we'll be talking about this in a little bit more depth. Thank you for joining this week's discussion, and I look forward to seeing you next week. Stay positive. See you next week. Thank you for watching the video. If you liked the content and you liked what you saw, don't forget to hit the like button below and subscribe to my channel, where I'll be sharing more content with you. If there's something that you would like me to talk about, please pop it in the comments below. See you next time. Stay positive.